Hi guys, welcome back. So as you guys can see, today we are going to talk about Indian Contract Act, and today we are going to learn about the topic communication. So what is communication? Communication is, as you all know, to communicate, to make things known to other people. So communication is a very important part of Indian contract, and it can be further divided into communication of offer, communication of acceptance, and communication of revocation of offer and acceptance. The sections that deal with communication are section 3. Hope you guys can see, and because there's a lot of sunshine and I'm not able to look at the camera properly. So the sections that deal with the communication are section 3 and section 4 of the Indian Contract Act. So what does section 3 says? Section 3 deals with how communication can be made. Communication can be basically made with any act or with any omission of by the party communicating, any act or any omission which has the effect of communicating. The offer acceptance and the revocation of offer and acceptance can be communicated by any act or any omission by the party who wants to communicate, but that act or that omission should have the effect of communicating. If it is something, any random act, then the act cannot be said to communicate the following thing, the required thing that the person wanted to communicate. Now what does section 4 says? Section 4 says when communication is complete. Now section 4 can further be divided into these following things. The first part is communication of offer when complete. When is the communication of offer complete? It is complete when the offer comes to the knowledge of the acceptor, and before that the offer is not complete and the offeror is at liberty to revoke the offer at any time before the offer comes to the knowledge of the acceptor. So the offer is only complete when the knowledge of the offer comes to the acceptor, and not before that. Now when is communication of acceptance complete? It can be further divided into two parts, it from the point of view of the offerer and the point of view of the acceptor. When the communication of acceptance is complete from the point of view of the offerer, when the acceptance is put in due course of transmission. If the acceptance is sent by letter or anything, then when the letter is put in course of transmission, then it is complete against the offerer. Our communication of acceptance is complete against the offerer when the communication is put in course of transmission, and the communication of acceptance is complete against the acceptor when it reaches the offerer and not before that. So suppose if A is communicating acceptance to B by letter, then A is at liberty to revoke the acceptance at any point of time before the letter reaches B and not after that. Now the third part of section 4 is communication of revocation. It is again further divided into two parts, as against the person making the revocation and as against the person to whom it is made. The communication of revocation is complete as against the person making it when it is put in course of transmission, and as against the person to whom it is made when it comes to his knowledge. So that's it for today. See you in my next video. Bye bye.